Welcome back to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Oppmann. Bygone Nashville is a terrific website that uses multimedia storytelling skills to explore the history of Nashville neighborhoods. It was created through the work of Assistant Professor Molly Taylor-Poleskey in our Department of History. Now, she teaches digital history in the College of Liberal Arts. The professor joins us via Zoom with one of her students, Audrey Creel, to talk about this project. Well, welcome both of you to the program.
Glad to be here.
Thank you for having us.
It means so much to have you on this Zoom edition of Out of the Blue. Well, Professor, I've got to tell you, as a content geek myself, I love your website. This is a rich, interesting site with a lot of great things to explore. Talk about how it got created, why it got created, and what you're trying to accomplish with it.
This website was created almost completely by undergraduate students in my digital public history class. And the beauty of doing public history is that it's not topic specific. You can really delve into new topics, whatever is pertinent to that locality. So with the students in this class, I try and bring that to our appreciation of our local surroundings again. And I start the class with just observations. And Audrey can tell you a little bit more about those experiences of listening, looking, observing things that we don't normally see on the landscape.
Audrey, she kind of sets you up for the next question I'm going to ask, which is how do you get at the layers of this type of storytelling?
It really just started by walking East Nashville. I wasn't very familiar with the area, and most of the places that I ended up writing about were just places that I found while I was walking, and it kind of piqued my interest, and I wanted to learn more about it. I started with newspaper research. It gives you a good personal look at the areas that you're trying to research, as well as other secondary sources that might explain why a building looks the way it does, and how that can contribute to a broader narrative of United States history or even world history.
Can you describe for our viewers your project? You've mentioned East Nashville. Tell us what you're diving into in that particular area.
Our class last semester looked at East Nashville just as a region, and we were each assigned a specific block that each student was researching. And so we picked three or four buildings within that block that we researched. And these buildings were anything from old houses that dated to early 1800s to a shopping mall at one point. And so we were able to take all that research for our individual blocks and then find common themes, stuff like religious history in Nashville started coming up, or architectural history, tribal history even. And so we started taking those themes that were applied in different ways and used that to create a public walking tour that we led at the end of the semester.
Wow. Wow. Professor, I'm really intrigued on how you begin this process. You're in a lot of ways like a magazine editor. How do you go through the idea process of finding what you're going to tackle in a semester's class, what kind of variety you're going to put up, and really honing down on the topics you're going to explore?
I like to focus on a micro section, and that's why I break it down even smaller. As Audrey mentioned, she got a block or a street to focus on, because sometimes if you read secondary sources, you don't know how to read the city itself. So as I mentioned before, I focus on observations. Something as simple as a deviation in how a street lines up may actually tell you about an important historical decision that was made in the development of that city. And that, I think, is nowhere more obvious than in East Nashville. We're seeing gentrification, yes, but an incredible turnover in the way that East Nashville looks because of the recent tornado. And of course, natural disasters are not new to East Nashville. That was one of the stories that the students in this class kept turning up. Floods and tornadoes and fires, all of the different ways that East Nashville's history has changed over time. And now I think for the next class, we can move on to a new neighborhood, and I'm looking to move on to North Nashville.
Wow, wow. Well, your professor did a good job setting you up, Audrey, for the next question, which is talk about the Nashville sites project she mentioned and your work in that and what you're learning from those opportunities.
Yeah, they are located in Nashville and they are heading up a really great website and program in Nashville to establish certain tours that are all self-guided, but they don't have any tours located in East Nashville right now. And so what they have asked me to do is take all the stories that have been written for the Bygone Nashville project and help kind of consolidate that into a walking tour.
Did you have any idea when you were signing up for this class that this is the work that you were going to be doing and we're entering registration? Would you recommend this to prospective students?
Yeah, I would absolutely recommend this course to other students. It wasn't what I thought it was going to be, but it has been so helpful in helping me take all the research that you have to do, even for, I think our stories are only 400 words a piece, but it's still mountains of research that you have to do. And how do you take all that research and make it easy to read and tell a full story and make it available to the public? And so that has been very helpful to what I am hoping to do after graduation.
And that's terrific. And we could spend a whole episode on just the two of you. But Professor, there's something over your shoulder that has been intriguing me the whole time that that we've switched camera to you. What is that? What are you advertising over there?
One of the things that the students do, we talk about how to publicize our tour. And this is the poster. This is from this year. And these are things that the students are asked to use all of their skills, things they learn in other classes, or just interests they have. And then we went out and we posted this poster around East Nashville. And I mailed it to parties that I thought would be interested up in Nashville and people around here in Murfreesboro to advertise our tour.
Well, Professor, thank you so very much for sharing all of this information with us and talking about this great course. Audrey, best of luck to you. You're graduating senior in December. Hope to see you on campus soon. Congratulations to you both, and thanks for joining the program.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Thank you.